Hey buddy, this is the Old School Gamer, bringing you another clip from the wonderful world of warships. So, I'm really truly sorry guys for being AWOL on the channel for so long. But if you guys recall from my last upload, I was talking about a major huge project that I was involved in my workplace. Well, that project has gone live since then, so I have been pretty much working around the clock on that one. So there hasn't been that much for playing video games and editing and of course uploading to YouTube. But now things will calm down for a little bit, so it will be much better in the future. So today I'm playing one of my absolute favorite ships in the game, the Tier 8 Japanese destroyer hunter killer, the Akizuki. And if you watch my channel anything at all before, you know that I like to play this ship. I mean, it's an insane powerful ship that is extremely fun to play, and it is a must-have for anyone who likes to play aggressive and also of course enjoy destroyer gameplay. So this will definitely get my stamp of approval and recommendation if you haven't grinded to this ship yet. And also of course it's some great news for everyone who loves this destroyer line, and that is of course that Wargaming announced recently that this destroyer line, this subline that Akizuki is part of, will soon receive a tier 9 and a tier 10 as well. And that is music to my ears, because I really love this ship, and I can't wait to be able to try out the newer tier 9 and 10 of this destroyer line. And as you may know, if you watch my earlier Akizuki videos, you know that this is also the ship that I highly recommend you putting your Yamamoto special captain on, if you have that captain from that campaign. Because if it's one Japanese ship that you will be able to earn both First Blood and Kraken in, it's this ship, as I have done many times in my earlier videos. So if you want to check those out, please go to my channel and just click on my Akizuki playlist. There you will see a whole lot of videos where I get both First Blood and of course Kraken Unleashed with my Yamamoto captain in this ship, earning me of course that sweet 1.6 second reload, I think it is, and also that crazy Conqueror heal for this ship. So the match hasn't really started out well for us. This is of course the neighbor's map, and it's a 3 cap domination mode. I went straight for the A cap because I think it's a good cap to go for when you are in Akizuki, because you can cut across the ocean and pretty much decimate any destroyer that is facing you at the A cap. And before the enemy team has a chance to react, you can pretty much duck in behind that northern islands on the A cap. So it's a pretty good strategy, I think. But I was uncontested, so I managed to cap the A cap for our team. Meanwhile, the enemy team managed to take the B and the C cap, and of course killing off the other destroyer on our team. So I'm alone against two destroyers, which isn't really that great. And of course, after me capping the A cap a couple of minutes ago, and it's clear that none of the enemy ships are at the A cap, half my team decides to head for the A cap. I mean, why shouldn't they? So I am in the process of capping the B cap for my team and starting to engage this enemy Amagi. I managed to land a torp on him, and since then I put two permafires, because this ship, even though it doesn't really tell you if you check the paper stats on this ship, is a really, really potent fire starter. I think the fire chance on these 100mm guns are, I think, maybe 7% or something. But you have to consider the amount of shells that you spew out, and of course the insane fire rate of these guns. And then when you consider that as well, the fire chance pretty much adds up. And I would say that I think my record in fires is with this ship. So I managed to cap the B cap, and now my job is pretty much to harass all the enemy ships that are trying to push this cap, because I want to pretty much break up the enemy lines. Now the enemy team has a enemy Belfast, which is not that great news for me, because he's one of the biggest threats for me. So I managed to set some fires to this enemy battleship, and it looks like actually he's gonna eat a torp of mine as well. Now he did repair the fires, but yeah, his repair just went out before my torp hit, so I managed to get a permaflood and a permafire on that guy. So he's dead, but of course someone else gets a kill. Why not? It's the name of the game. So I'm just fiddling about with some of the settings here, because playing this ship, if you have sound settings too high, you will pretty much go deaf. Because it's just constant fire all the time. It's pretty much like playing the Khabarovsk in that sense. The only difference is that the Khabarovsk can actually dodge some incoming fire, and this ship is really, really dependent on smoke screens to be able to sit and daka-daka on the enemy ships. So now I'm pretty much just patrolling a line at the B-cap, pretty much engaging any enemy ship that is ballsy enough to start pushing the B-cap. Trying to land some fires on this enemy battleship. And as you can see, I'm up to my fifth fire. And this is just the power of the Akizuki. You don't do that much damage with your guns unless you get a fully broadsiding ship and you use your armor piercing, but these fires will add up. And we got hit with a cyclone. I see the B cap is contested, so I need to return back to the B cap and try to defend it as much as possible. I don't really know why our ships that was sailing around the A-cap, even though I have capped the A-cap for ages ago, are still sailing around the whole map. They are right now in the enemy spawn, heading away, it looks like. And I mean, we really need these guys at the B cap, helping us defend the B cap, tanking damage and such. And this is when I run into the enemy Jork, and I don't really have any kind of backup here, so of course I need to strap on the man pants and do my thing. And as you can see, my armor piercing is really devastating to any cruiser dumb enough to show broadside to me. I anticipate him sending torps, so of course I slow down and turn in and start chasing him. He's angled, so I start to blast him with my HE instead, and of course there is his torps. I managed to land two permafires on him, and of course the Colorado takes that kill as well. But before that, I saw that the enemy Harakase was lurking around in his smoke screen close to B, so I send off two sets of torps towards that smoke screen, because you know, guys, what smoke screens are. They are torpedo magnets. And no self-respecting destroyer captain should be sitting broadside on in a smoke screen. Especially when a enemy destroyer has been spotted at close ranges. But my torpedoes make contact and I kill off the last remaining destroyer on the enemy team. So another enemy battleship closes in, so I need to try and take him out, but then a wild Belfast appear. So I land a fire on him and I take him out as well, earning me my third kill of the game. So this has been a pretty tough carry from the start to the end. But the game isn't over yet. So it's pretty much me and this friendly Colorado in the B cap, and of course one of the pretty worthless division guys that has been sailing around the map borders the entire game is now up north, because he has been sailing across the enemy spawn and is now trying to take the C-cap, which is probably the first good thing that he is trying to do in this game. But I digress. I have this enemy Amagi pushing the B-cap and my friendly Colorado, so of course I need to try and help him out to take this guy out as quickly as possible, because he has two allied pushing in behind him. So I managed to land a permafire on him, and it actually looks like my torps is gonna be efficient once again. So I kill off the Amagi as well, earning me my fourth kill of the game, and my health is really, really low, and here comes the next enemy battleship, the Queen Elizabeth. And this ship is perfectly capable of taking me out in one shot. So I need to work this ship down quickly as well. I managed to land a fire on her, and my damage numbers are stacking up really fast. I get a second fire on her as well, but my smoke screen is starting to dissipate. So I'm just trying to work her down as quickly as possible. She used her repair, and then suddenly the other ship pops up, and it's a really low health Gneisse now, and of course this will be a really easy kill for me to finish, and earning me Kraken Unleashed.
So bad. Oh.
Hello, beastie.
I just love that comment. Wasn't that bad? And of course you can see with the Yamamoto Kraken I get my insane Conqueror heal on this ship, and also a totally insane 1.6 second reload of these already extremely powerful guns. So I landed a permafire and also have incoming torps. And this guy is toast. So, earning me my 6th kill of the game. And the game is over. I landed on almost 500,000 credits. Over 170,000 damage done. 2 caps. 6 kills. Kraken Unleashed. Confederate, high caliber, oh my. 2,600 base XP, and also a big shout out to the Belfast player on the enemy team, Eternity, who also had an insanely good game with 6 kills. And if you consider that I almost had 2 more kills in this game, you probably understand why I always run my Yamamoto Captain on this ship. It's insanely strong. And as a kind of finishing touch, I wanted to show you guys why you never ever try and contest or smoke fire a Akizuki. Not even if you are a Hydro German destroyer. In this case, I come up against a US Tier 9 Fletcher, which is considered one of the strongest destroyers in the game. Many consider the Fletcher being even stronger than the Tier 10 Gearing. And I mean, not even Fletcher can stand up to the Akizuki's insane fire rate and DPM. So I pushed the sea cap, and I know there's an enemy destroyer lurking about. I anticipated torps, and there they go. And I get spotted, and then I spot the enemy Fletcher. And this is where my DPM comes into play. Because it doesn't even matter if I lose visibility on him. If he tries to smoke fire me, I can just look at his shells, adjust my firing, and well, work him down pretty much. So while this game plays out, I want to thank you guys so much for checking out this video. Please leave a like and a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more amazing gameplays. Now it's Saturday, so I'm gonna do some nice umbrella drinks and play some World of Warships. So I see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.